Good morning, children. Stay safely at home. So I am starting the next chapter, that is isothermal and adiabatic process. That is the name of the chapter. So one by one I will discuss very important topic, concept wise also, exam wise also. So from the beginning try to understand each and every topic discussed. So first is the isothermal process. Now, isothermal process is what? The process during which the temperature of the system remain constant. Alright? So, that is the first criteria, and due to that only it is known as, the name of the process is known as isothermal process. Means temperature of the system should remain constant. Now, if you want to keep the temperature of a thermodynamic system constant, then system should be surrounded by perfectly conducting material. Alright, understand why? Because you see, whenever any system expands, then cooling takes place, temperature of the system decreases. So if you want to keep the temperature of the system constant, then during expansion, system should absorb heat from outside. Alright, so if the system is not surrounded by conducting material, it won't be able to absorb heat from the surroundings. Alright, in opposite way, think that when a system is compressed, then temperature of the system increases. Alright, so if the temperature of the system, you want to keep it constant, then heat should be released from the system to the surroundings. So if the system is not surrounded by perfectly conducting material, then system won't be able to release heat to the surroundings. Alright, so the basic concept is, the process will be isothermal only when the system is allowed to absorb heat or to release it from the surrounding in order to keep its temperature constant. Alright, during expansion it will absorb heat from the surrounding, and during compression it will release heat to the surrounding. So this exchange of heat with the surrounding is possible only when the system is surrounded by conducting material. That's why the second is, system should be surrounded by perfectly conducting material. That's why we consider the system like this. You see, this is the piston, as you know. So this is the piston and the ideal gas, it is surrounded by conducting material. These all the three sides, these are conducting. Okay, then next is, the process should take place very slowly. Why? If it takes place very fast, then system may not be able to exchange heat with the surroundings in order to keep the temperature constant. That's why this is the third point, important point related with the isothermal process. That process should take place very slowly. Alright? Now, for isothermal process, Boyle's law, already in chemistry lower classes you have studied that the product of pressure and volume, it is constant. P is the pressure and V is the volume. So if you take derivative of both sides, you can write like this, P dV means pressure, the first quantity, into derivative of the second quantity, plus, this is the rule of derivative, then second quantity into derivative of the first quantity. Alright. Now, derivative of the constant is 0. So, what you are getting, P dV plus V dP is equal to 0. So, if you plot P versus V graph. Alright, if you plot P versus V graph for isothermal process, then you will see that it is like this. Alright, it is deeper. It is not, when I will discuss the adiabatic process, then you will understand that when it is isothermal, then this is dip. This curve is deeper. Is that clear? So you see, at any point, if you want to find out, so in this one, from this one mathematically, what you can write? That VdP is equal to minus PdV. Therefore, dpdV, alright, dpdV is equal to minus P by V. Now, what does dpdV represent? At any point, if you draw a tangent, alright, if you draw a tangent, then slope of the tangent is given by dpdV. Means, if you want to find out the slope of an isothermal curve at any point, then you have to find out dpdV. Alright, so dpdV is how much? You have got minus P by V. Is that clear? Now, negative sign indicates what? Negative sign indicates that, why there is a negative sign coming here? Negative sign indicates that when P increases, then volume decreases. Means if you change P, if you increase, then what will happen to the volume? Volume will decrease. Alright? So, these are the basic concept related with the isothermal process. I repeat, point wise, that during first point is, during isothermal process, temperature remain constant. Then, second point, system should be surrounded by perfectly conducting material. Third point, the process should take place very slowly. Then fourth point, for Boyle's law, what is the relation between pressure and volume? PV equal to constant. What will be the nature of the pressure versus volume graph? It will be a curve like this. Curve should be dip. And then at any point, if you draw the tangent, then slope of the curve is given by dpdV. It represents the slope is equal to how much? Minus P by V. And why there is a negative sign? Negative sign indicates that when pressure increases, then volume decreases. So I have noted down all the important points related with this isothermal process. You kindly do that and also learn point wise and remember the highlighted portion. Okay. Now next is coming adiabatic process. So you know what is adiabatic process? Adiabatic process means where the total heat of the system remain constant. That is known as adiabatic process. So it means what? That total heat of the system will remain constant when the system neither will release it to the surrounding nor absorb heat from the surrounding. Means there will not be any exchange of heat between the system and the surrounding. So it is very easy to understand. When the system won't be able to exchange heat with the surroundings, when it is surrounded by perfectly insulating material. That's why whenever we consider the system for this one, we draw like this. This is perfect insulator. Alright. This is insulator and this is the piston. So, this is perfect insulator. Perfect insulator, remember. Then, next one is, in case of adiabatic process, the process should take place very fast. Why? Because if it takes place slowly, then, because you know, in nature, nothing perfect is possible. So, perfect insulator is not available. It may be insulated, but if you allow the system process take place very slowly, then the system may exchange a little bit of heat with the surroundings. That's why this is the third point, that process should take place very fast. Alright. So, regarding the adiabatic process, what are the main 3 points you have to remember? That total heat of the system remain constant. Second point, the system should be surrounded by perfect insulator. Perfectly insulating material. You can write perfect insulator also. Then, process should take place very fast. Alright. Then, next point. Boyle's law, if you consider for adiabatic process, it is given by PV to the power gamma equal to constant. In case of isothermal process, what was the Boyle's law? That for a constant amount of gas, constant mass of gas, PV constant. But when it is adiabatic process, then Boyle's law, it will take the form PV to the power gamma equal to constant. Where gamma is equal to specific heat capacity at constant pressure by specific heat capacity at constant volume. I will repeat this concept once again later on this chapter. So Cp by Cv, all right, gamma is equal to Cp by Cv. So you see, if you differentiate both the sides, you will get first P, then differentiation of this will be gamma V to the power gamma minus 1 dV, then next one will be plus V to the power gamma dP, and derivation of the constant is 0. So you see, you can take V to the power gamma you can take common. So it will become P gamma dV by V. It is V to the power minus 1 means 1 by V, it will come down. Then dP equal to 0. Is that clear? So you see, you are getting P gamma dV by V plus dP is equal to 0. So you are getting dP by dV, I have just jumped one step, it will be minus P gamma by V. Is that clear? So this dP dV, once again it represent the slope of the adiabatic graph. Now if you plot P versus V graph for adiabatic, then you will see that it is steeper. Alright, that this is not very deep. For isothermal, it is deep like this. But for adiabatic, it is steeper. Is that clear? And in this case also, that dP by dV, what will be the slope of the graph for adiabatic? It is given by minus P gamma by V. Is that clear? In this case also, negative sign indicates what? Negative sign indicates when pressure increases, then volume decreases and vice versa. So you are supposed to remember first 3 points related with the adiabatic process. Then what will be the nature of the P versus V graph? It will be a curve, but the curve is steeper. Curve is steeper, alright, and then Boyle's law take the form P V to the power gamma equal to constant, where gamma is Cp by Cv, and slope of the graph is given by dP by dV minus P gamma by V. Is that clear? So these are the point, this part, these steps, as you have not done calculus, so if you cannot follow this part, then remember the result, alright. That dP dV, which represent the slope of the graph, is given by minus P gamma by V. Okay, so these are the important points related with the adiabatic process. So adiabatic curve is steeper than isothermal curve. Alright, how you can prove this? What if we use the result of the previous result? Result of the previous discussion, dP dV for slope, this is for isothermal, this is for isotherms, isn't it? We have got, then dP dV, that is the slope for adiabatic curve, it is given by minus gamma P by V. This is for adiabats, we say adiabats, alright, or isotherms. Clear? So you see, if you consider this is equation 2 and this is equation 1. So if you divide equation 2 by equation 1, then you see what you are getting, dP dV for adiabat. Alright, I have written in short, adiabat divided by dP dV for isotherm. Okay, isotherm, what will happen when you will divide, you see negative sign PV, you will get cancelled, so you are getting only gamma. Is that clear? So you are getting that dP dV for adiabatic, it is equal to gamma into dP dV of isotherm. What does it mean? That it means that slope of adiabat is greater than slope of isotherm. So when the slope is greater, it means that adiabatic curves are steeper. Alright, So this is a common question, very common, frequently asked question, that show that adiabatic curve is steeper than isothermal curve. So one can show like this, that if the slope of the adiabat as slope of the adiabat is greater than slope of the isotherm, so adiabatic curve is steeper. All right. So if you consider P versus V graph, suppose initially there is a point here. Now you have taken the system adiabatically to some other point. Then what will happen? That you will see that volume will, means the curve will be like this. All right. Both of them are having the same volume. Then this will be isotherm and this will be adiabat. Is that clear? Slope is bigger. And if you do the opposite, means if you contract the volume, okay, if you contract the volume, then you will observe that the graph will be like this. In this case, this will be the adiabatic curve and this will be isotherm. Alright, so this is the comparison of the adiabatic curve and isothermal curve. Alright. Now next topic, also a very important topic and favorite topic of the examiner, that what will be the work done by an ideal gas when it expands isothermally. What does it mean? That suppose you have taken mu mole, means how many moles you have taken? Mu mole of gas, and which is expanding isothermally, expanding from initial volume V1 to final volume V2 at constant temperature T. Alright, now we know that in case of thermodynamic system, work done is given by integration P dV and integration will be V1 to V2. Okay, now for isothermal process, you know that isothermal process, what is the gas equation? That PV is equal to mu RT. Already we studied. So you see, you can write P is equal to mu RT divided by V. So work done, you can write it at integration V1 to V2 mu RT by V dV. Now mu RT, all are constant. Mu is the number of mole constant, R is the universal gas constant, T temperature, which is constant. So you see, you can take mu RT outside the derivation. So you are having integration V1 to T dV by V. Now integration dV by V is equal to log V. Integration dV by V is log V. Log V, we have written ln, means to base is E. So, and you have to put the limit V1 to V2. So you are getting that mu RT from here. This is the step. So you are getting mu RT, then it will be log V2 minus log V1. Now log V2 minus log V1, you can write it as mu RT log V2 by V1. Alright, so what is the work done you have got? Work done is equal to mu RT log V2 by V1. Is that clear? Again, according to Boyle's law, PV equal to constant. So PV equal to constant means what? You see here, if you consider PV equal to constant, what does it mean? P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. So you see, V2 by V1 is equal to P1 by P2. So in place of V2 by V1, you can write it as mu RT log P1 by P2. So this is the final expression for the work done by an ideal gas when it expands isothermally. What is the expression? Mu RT log V2 by V1, or you can get mu RT log P1 by P2. Next is, work done by an ideal gas in adiabatic process. Means now the gas is expanding adiabatically. Temperature may not remain constant. Alright. So let us consider that mu mole of the gas is taken and the volume is increasing from V1 to V2. So we have to calculate what is the work done. So in this case also, what will be the work done? Integration V1 to V2 PdV. Alright. Now, we know that for adiabatic process, alright, for adiabatic process, one can write that PV to the power gamma is equal to constant. So, let us denote that constant by K. So, you see you are getting K, P is equal to K by V to the power gamma. Alright, means K into V to the power minus gamma. So, you see if you substitute P in equation 1, then from equation 1, what are you getting? W is equal to integration K V to the power minus gamma dV, integration V1 to V2. Is that clear? So, you see, you can right, if you integrate it, what you will get? It will be V to the power minus gamma plus 1 divided by minus gamma plus 1. And then you have to put the limit V1 to V2. So, you see, if you take K divided by 1 minus gamma, K divided by 1 minus gamma common, then you are getting it is V to the power minus gamma plus 1 minus V1 to the power minus gamma plus 1. Alright, that there is no place. So, I have to rub the upper steps. So, you see what we have to do. I am just taking it here. So, you can write W is equal to what we will do. We will take K inside. So, you can write it as minus 1 by 1 minus gamma, then it will be K V2 to the power minus gamma plus 1, then minus K V1 minus gamma plus 1. Alright, now you see, we know that K you can write it as P1 V1, alright, or K you can write it as P1 V1 to the power gamma or P2 V2 to the power gamma. Because K is P1 V1 constant and P2 V2 to the power gamma equal to constant. So, you see, when you will substitute K, then what you will do? Here, it is V2. So, you will take K as P2 V2 to the power gamma. So, it will be K is P2 V2 to the power gamma, then already V2 minus gamma plus 1. Here, K is multiplied by V1. So, in this case, you substitute K by P1 V1 gamma. So, you are getting P1 V1 gamma, then V1 to the power minus gamma plus 1. Okay, as this is the point thing. Okay, don't get this one, as K is equal to this. So, we have just substituted K here. In the first term, K we have taken P2 V2 to the power gamma. In the second, we have taken P1 V1 to the power gamma. So, you see what are you getting? 1 by 1 minus gamma V2 to the power gamma minus. So, when you will add up, then you see gamma minus gamma, it will be 0. So, it will be 1 only. So, you can write it is P2 V2 minus P1 V1. Again, you can write like this. P2 V2 is nothing but mu RT2. Alright. Because we know that PV equal to mu RT. So, when it is P1 V1 means initially, then it will be the initial temperature mu RT1. So, and in case of P1 V1, you can write it as mu RT1. Alright. Next step is very simple. You take mu r common. So, it will be mu r 1 minus gamma, then T2 minus T1. Here one point you have to understand. Gamma generally for diatomic gases, the value of gamma is 1.41, means greater than 1. So, 1 minus gamma is negative. So, if you want to overcome that negative 1, what you can do? You take, and here in this case also, T2 is lower than T1. So, T1 is greater than T2. So, you take negative sign common. So, it will become T1 minus T2. And this negative when you will take common, then it will become gamma. gamma minus 1. So this is the expression for the work done by an ideal gas in adiabatic process. In isothermal process, it was mu r log V2 by V1 or mu r log P1 by P2. So these two thing work done, the final expression at least you must learn and remember. So let us summarize the points that what are the differences between isothermal process and adiabatic process. In case of isothermal process, temperature of the system remain constant. In case of adiabatic process, total heat of the system remain constant. Then second point is associated with the first point. You know that from the concept of the internal energy, when temperature of a system remain constant, then internal energy also remain constant. So in case of isothermal process, internal energy remain constant. But in case of adiabatic process, internal energy changes because temperature is not constant for adiabatic process. Then we know for isothermal process, the system should be surrounded by perfect conductor. Whereas in case of adiabatic process, the system should be surrounded by perfect insulator. Then we know that in case of isothermal process, the process should be carried out very slowly. Whereas for adiabatic process, the process should be carried out very fast. And then we know that for isothermal process, dpdv means the slope is given by minus p by v, whereas in case of adiabatic process, the slope dpdv is given by minus gamma p by v. Then we know that in isothermal process, it obeys Boyle's law, PV equal to constant. But in case of adiabatic process, Boyle's law should be modified. And that modified Boyle's law is known as Poisson's law. And what is the modification done? That instead of PV equal to constant, it should be PV to the power gamma equal to constant, where gamma is Cp by Cv. Cp is the specific heat capacity of the gas at constant pressure, and Cv is the specific heat capacity of the gas at constant volume. So I have just summarized all the points here. So you must note it down, means every point you must note it down as it is written, and please learn it and remember it, and it is important for your exam. That's all for today. Thank you, children.